We're awake.
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. How is everybody out there in TV land?
Excellent.
How's the praise band?
Awesome. Excellent.
Good morning. You ready to praise his name?
Yes.
Get a little out of our minds and a little into the spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
All right, let's make a joyous noise.
For this day, we're gathered in your name, calling out to you. Your glory like the fire, awakened desire, will burn our hearts with truth. Your love is with you, your love is with you. So open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our breast. Your presence in this place, your glory on our face, we're looking to the sky. Descending like a cloud, you're standing with us now, Lord. Your love is with me. So open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our breast. So open up the heavens, we want to see you. A mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our breast.
Raise it up and let it go. Here we go.
Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord.
Lord, we know with you, we're free from fear. We're free from despair. We're delivered from anger. And our souls are truly set free. Lord, this morning, we raise a prayer to all those we know who are suffering, who have lost their way, and can't seem to find their way back to the cross. Lord, come into their hearts and change them. Help them to find the victory in Christ, the right life, the right road. Lord, this morning we lift up those names, we lift up our fears, we lift up all that is troubling us, and we know that with your power and your love, we can overcome. Let's take a moment of silent meditation and contemplate the glory of our amazing God. Thank you.
pray for all the students that are going back to school now, whether it's virtually or in person, and all the teachers that are figuring out life right now. We're all in this together, and let's just have a little bit of grace with one another.
Amen. Amen.
Of saints were singing glory and hallelujah and worthy is the Lamb. The Lamb who was slain. The Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, took all of the sins of the world into his body on the cross, that we might no longer be enslaved by sin, that we would be dead to sin and alive to all that is good. So know that you are forgiven and be at peace. And God's people say,
Amen.
Remember that you are loved beyond belief. You are accepted just the way you are. In God's eyes, you are a perfect creation. Enjoy the rest of worship, and we'll see you when, gang?
Next week.
Next week. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Good morning. I would like to greet you this morning with a greeting from Romans chapter 1. I greet you this morning with the words of the Apostle Paul, who said, "To all in Rome, loved by God, and called to be his holy people, grace and peace to you from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ." A reminder, if you weren't aware, we are doing communion this morning. So if you would like to grab the supplies you'll be using for communion, whether that be bread, wafers, juice, wine, whatever you are using for communion this morning to join us later on in the service, if you'd like to gather those supplies so you have them handy for when communion starts, we will be doing communion later on in the service. So while you're grabbing those, you can stand by for announcements up next. Good morning, church. Lauren here, coming to you from the park with announcements this morning. So I'm out for a morning stroll with my dog Norman and Connor, and this is the beauty of doing virtual church, that I can come to your homes from anywhere. So here I am out on my walk, multitasking, doing announcements. So first off, if you would like a socially distanced visit from Pastor David, please let us know. He is more than happy to come and do that. We welcome Anne back, who we had a visit with. If you would like one, please let David know. He is more than happy to come see you, pray with you, whatever you need. We have our movie night coming up on Wednesday with the youth. We are watching Breakthrough. Please RSVP to that. The film's going to start at 7:30. It looks really good. I'm really looking forward to seeing it. So if you would like to attend that movie, if you're an adult and you'd like to join to watch it or chaperone, please let me know. And if you are a youth, please let me know ASAP if you are going to be in attendance. It's going to be a fun night. Following that, the week after, youth groups are due to start up again. Parents, please fill out the online registration. Your child cannot come to youth group until you have filled that registration out. So please go online and fill the registration out. The registration to register for youth groups is in the description of our service video this morning. We also have an in-person worship event happening the next Sunday the 13th. Please email the office at fanwoodprayers@gmail.com if you would like to RSVP a space for some in-person worship. I've been to two now and they have been so much fun. Connor really enjoyed it last week, so I am really looking forward to the next one. So please make sure you RSVP your space out on the lawn for some in-person worship. We would love to see you there. Let us know if you have any prayer requests. If you need any help during this time, we would love to help you, chat with you, do what we can for you during this time, especially as the kids go back to school and do that remotely from home. So if you need help, prayer, just someone to talk to, let us know. We are here. Have a good morning, church, and enjoy the rest of the service.
Good morning, children of all ages. It's good to be with you again this day. I thought that I might today remind us a bit about our Staycation Bible School. I don't know how many of you actually participated in it, and some of you grown-ups listening in might have no idea what I was talking about, but we did have a different Vacation Bible School season this year. We called it Staycation Bible School, Feet That Follow. And the reason I thought we should remember about that again today is that some of you have already started this new school year. Some of you are about to start this new school year, and it's kind of not the same. Not the same at all. I know we'll probably keep talking about the fact that it's just not the same. And our Staycation Bible School wasn't the same either. But Jesus is still with us, even though things are not quite the same. And we need to remember that. And we need to remember that when we decide that we are going to follow Jesus, He doesn't leave us by ourselves. He doesn't ever leave us alone. Now, I was thinking about this again, and this was not part of the Vacation Bible School materials, But there's a passage in Scripture that talks about a young person listening to God and following what he said. It's a man named Jeremiah who was a prophet telling people about God. And he said when God first talked to him, he said, I don't know how to speak. I'm only a child. And God said to him, do not say I am only a child. You must go wherever I send you and say what I tell you to say. And don't be afraid, because I will always be with you. And then the Lord reached out his hand and touched my mouth and said, go. I will put my words in your mouths. So I wanted to remind you, all of you, that you can't say I'm a child and I can't talk about Jesus. And you can't say I'm too old to talk about Jesus, because no one is too young or too old to talk about Jesus. And some of the things that we learned in our Vacation Bible School, I wanted to just remind us of them again. We learned to know that our feet could follow Jesus wherever we wanted to go. They followed him. And we learned what it meant to follow Jesus. You can go back into some of the materials that we had online, and you can see activities, and grown-ups, you can do them too. Anybody can do them. And one of the things that we did was we took flat Jesus with us wherever we went. I had some help making my flat Jesus. Isn't he quite handsome? I love the hearts. My granddaughter and I made flat Jesus one day this summer, and I just took flat Jesus with me on a number of things. We know that we can trust Jesus wherever we go. We know that we can follow Jesus. We know that we can pray like Jesus. And that was one of the things that I've talked about before, but I take walks most every day. Some days when it's raining, I walk inside, but many times I pray for the people in my neighborhood. Do you walk around and pray for the people in your neighborhood? Some of them are having more hard times right now. Some of them are having great times. All of us are having unusual times. So pray for people in our neighborhood. And we can love the people in our neighborhood, love the people in our families. What can we do to show that we love people? Well, we can listen to them. We can help without even being told what to do. We can share what it means to follow Jesus wherever we go. And some of the things that we sometimes do, and I've got, yes, we have some of the things, are helping people who might not have as much to eat. Yeah, some people are more hungry, and even in our Fanwood area, I've heard that our food bank has been giving food to 50 plus families once a month, families that need food of all kinds. I brought some of the things I bring, my cans, Cheerios, treats, whatever. Especially on Tuesdays. Well, now that you're back in school, you can't do it, but maybe some of the grown-ups in your life can. Tuesday afternoons, we collect at Fanwood Church for our food bank, or anytime, because people are hungry and we who have a lot can help them. And then we can carry God's love with us wherever we go. As I said before, we can continue to love one another, even in our school situations, which is a little different. We can listen to our teachers. We can listen to our parents. We can help others. We can share with our brothers and sisters at home. We can help where we can. If we don't understand something, we can ask for help. Or if we do understand something, we can give help to somebody else. Any kind of way that we can reach out and show one another how much we care. That is sharing the love of Jesus wherever we go. And we can continue to carry God's love and to be those wonderful people who follow Jesus. We've decided to follow Jesus. We're never too young or too old to tell about how much Jesus loves us and loves the world and wants to be with us every single day, every single minute of every single day. And we can get to know him more by reading our Bibles, by listening to worship, by singing, by praying, by talking to others. We will really come to know Jesus even more, and how exciting that is. And I want to pray the prayer that we prayed most days when we were finishing our staycation Bible school this year. We thank you, Jesus, for this day. As we follow you along the way, we will travel day and night to follow you and share your light. Help us journey far and near to share God's love with all who hear. And let's do it. Amen.
Good morning. A letter of Paul to the Romans. We're reading from Romans chapter 1, verses 1 to 7. Listen for the word of God. Paul, a servant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, set apart for the gospel of God, which he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, the gospel concerning his son, who was descended from David according to the flesh, and descended and designated son of God in power according to the spirit of holiness by his resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom we have received grace and apostleship to bring about the obedience of faith for the sake of his name among all nations, including yourselves who are called to belong to Jesus Christ. To all God's beloved in Rome who are called to be saints, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. God of grace and peace, we pray that you would grace us this morning with a good word, that you would send your Holy Spirit into our hearts and minds, that our hearts would be warmed with your love, and that our minds would be enlightened with the ways of the kingdom of heaven. Teach us about you, so that knowing you better, we might better serve you in the world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So I'm going back to the beginning of Paul's letter to the Romans. And this letter of Paul's to the Romans is probably the most important theological document of the early church. And if that word theology intimidates you at all, don't let it. Theology simply means words about God. We're all called to be theologians. We're all called to come to know and share words about God. So let's dive into these deep words about God from the Apostle Paul. Paul says in his introduction that he had been set apart by the gospel and for the gospel to be an apostle and to be a servant. There's no better way to describe the life of a Christian, the way of Jesus. We are set apart from darkness by way of love and grace and peace and mercy, and we are sent out into the world. An apostle is someone who is sent out into the world to serve God's kingdom purposes. And just as Jesus was grabbed by the Spirit of God at his baptism and sent out into the wilderness to wrestle with demons, to wrestle with darkness, to reflect upon God's word, to consider and wonder and imagine the calling of God upon his life, the same thing happened to Paul, and we too are called to that same journey out into the wilderness. Before we are sent out into the world, we need to go inward and wrestle with the darkness and wrestle with that darkness in the light of God, which is victorious. After the Spirit grabbed Paul, when he was on his way to Damascus to persecute the church, Paul went into the desert himself. He went into Arabia to wrestle with the wrongs that he had done to the early church and wrestle with the wrongs that had been done to him as well, surely. The reason we do wrongs to others is because we ourselves have been wronged. And so we need to wrestle with those wrongs that have happened to us and the wrongs that we have done, so that by way of the cross, as we bring these to the cross, they are transformed. And instead of being destructive, they become salvific. So as Paul wrestled with the wrongs, he did all of this in the light of the kingdom of heaven, the gospel light of God's grace and peace. And Paul was flooded with mercy, and he did a complete 180 in his life. He realized that his calling was not about keeping his own fellow Jews in line, but rather his calling was to reach out to the lost sheep of the nations and draw them into the fold of God's love and justice and mercy. Sometimes the Spirit grabs us suddenly, as the Spirit did with Jesus and with Paul. Most often, the Spirit gradually infuses our lives and fills us with peace and with faith. I was always interested in philosophy and theology, and so I decided to become a religion major in college and a philosophy minor. I didn't have to study the Bible. I didn't have to take a Bible course whatsoever as a religion major, which says quite a bit. So when the Spirit grabbed me some 8 years later and filled me with peace, filled me with faith, I was flooded with mercy as well. The meaning, the power, and the purpose of my life came upon me. And I realized that I wasn't being called to graduate school or to law school. I was being called to seminary. I needed to wrestle with the faith of my forefathers and foremothers as well, just as Paul had to wrestle with his Old Testament scriptures and his Jewish faith. So many of you have not been grabbed by the Spirit in a powerful and sudden way like this, but you are equally filled with the Spirit of God. You have been infused with the Spirit in and through regular worship and Sunday school, in and through wonderful teachers and instructors, mentors, parents, people who have filled you with the gifts of faith and developed the gifts of the Spirit within you. But you are equally called to wrestle with your past, with your present, wrestle with matters of faith, wrestle with matters of life and death, and do so all in the light of the context of God's mercy. But you have to know that light very well. You have to come to know Jesus. Jesus, the revelation of the glory of the kingdom of heaven. And so if you haven't read a gospel, I strongly encourage you to please join me in my YouTube study of the gospel according to Mark. Share your questions, your doubts, your uncertainties. We all have them, and I'm glad to help you work your way through this, or else share them with others. There's so many good people who want to help you on your faith journey. We're also going to be working our way through Paul's letter to the Romans in our small groups that are starting this week, Tuesdays at 1 p.m. out on the church lawn, and Thursdays at 6:30 p.m. in the same place. So please come and join us. Let's together wrestle with the scriptures. Let's wrestle with the faith which has shaped us, the faith of our forefathers and mothers, so that we too might leave a legacy for our children and our grandchildren. I'm going to give you a chance to take a quick break from me and my sermon and enjoy some beautiful views of the greatest city of Jesus's and Paul's day. the city of Rome. And as you take in the beauty, I just pray that you think about the beautiful world and the beautiful life that God is calling you and all of us to. And remember that the Rome of today's world is only about 20 miles from us here in Fanwood, New Jersey. And what is God calling us to be as apostles sent out into Rome, the center of the most powerful empire in today's world? What is God calling us to in suburban New Jersey, wherever you are? God is wanting you to do wonderful things. We'll be thinking about this after the video, after the respite from me. Paul told the Romans that everything that happened to Jesus and everything that was happening to him and through him was actually prophesied in the scriptures, that God had a plan to show and to bring to the world the promised kingdom of heaven, the gift of eternal life, that Jesus and Paul were critical agents in this plan. The heart of the plan were the heavenly powers and principalities of love, justice, and mercy that Jesus and Paul and the other apostles proclaimed and shared, I think, like nobody else before them. Jesus to the heretical Samaritans and to the lost sheep of Israel. Paul to the quote-unquote foolish in Asia Minor and to the quote-unquote wise in Greece. At the end of Jesus' life, he went to the cross and died and was risen from the grave in order to finalize the good news that he had shared throughout his life, the good news that the kingdom of heaven was real and that it was near. Paul proclaimed cross and resurrection, and through this proclamation and through his example, led his own people and led the Gentiles into the reality and the nearness of the kingdom of heaven. And all of this, they said, was prophecy being fulfilled. The prophecy of God to Abraham, that through Abraham's descendants, all the nations of the world would be blessed. And the prophecies of Jeremiah and Isaiah and Ezekiel, that one day all the nations of the world would come and honor the Lord, and that the law would be written on human hearts, and that sins would be forgiven. All of these blessings blossomed in and through Paul and Jesus and other simple and good Jews in ways that had never happened before. And God's covenant with Abraham, with the Jews, was new and was shared with the whole world. Over the last 150 years in America, we have seen the nations flock to this Judeo-Christian nation. And just like the Jews and the Gentiles of Jesus' and Paul's day had a choice about the messages of Jesus and Paul and the other apostles, the same goes for us today. And Paul's introduction to the Romans essentially points us to consider, believe in, and pursue the wonders of Christmas and Easter. And so some questions for you. Was a baby born to a young woman named Mary in Bethlehem? Did eternal light shine upon the world at Christmas time and call us to share presents with one another? Is God calling us to share all the gifts of creation with one another as one human family? Is God embodied in the baby born in Bethlehem? Is God embodied in the miracle worker from Nazareth? Is God embodied in the great teacher and prophet who wandered around in Galilee? Some 30 years later, did Jesus actually die on a cross, and was he risen from the grave? Or did his followers, his simple, seemingly good followers, make this stuff up in order to further a false Messiah and also to be persecuted just as he was persecuted? Or did they actually see the risen Jesus as both Paul and the evangelists, the gospel writers, said that they did many, many times? These are questions that I urge you to explore. And what happens when we believe the heart of Jesus's message and Paul's message is that the heavenly powers and principalities of justice and love and mercy blossom in and around us like they never had before, and they keep blossoming as we keep growing in faith. Greed and infidelity and condemnation of others, deceit, these are not just the way of humanity. These are not norms to be accepted. They are to be resisted. And instead, the eternal norms of justice and goodness and mercy and truth and trust and giving and forgiving, these are the eternal norms that are coming into the world in and through the Spirit. And by way of faith, we hear this calling and we pursue this calling. And choose wisely, friends. And may we together bring true and eternal life to the world. Through the one who can do far more abundantly in us than all we can ask or imagine, to God be glory in Christ Jesus and the church now and forevermore. And God's people say. So I just heard some relatively good news on the radio. The unemployment numbers were not as bad as expected in August. And so I hope that you've received some good news. And on this Labor Day weekend, let's continue to lift up our neighbors who are in need. The church is in need, let me be frank with you. And so if you have enjoyed these videos, the Bible studies, the music, the sermons, if they've been meaningful to you during this pandemic, I pray that you would consider offering a gift to the church. And more importantly still, in the long run, the church will be fine. In the short term, continue to give to charitable organizations and make sure that you give of your gifts, your spiritual gifts, to your neighbors in need. Let us now offer up to the Lord the offerings of our lives and our labor. Thank you.
This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, after supper, he took the cup and he said, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you and for the whole world for the forgiveness of sins. Every time you drink this, do it in remembrance of me." When the risen Lord broke the bread, suddenly the disciples' eyes were opened and they recognized him. So let us pray that the Lord would open our eyes to the love, the grace, the peace in which we live, move, and have our being. Please join me in the prayer of great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right, O Lord, to give you all the praise and glory, for you created this wonderful world and filled it with mountains and valleys, with oceans, rivers, lakes, filled it with plants and animals and so many good things. You filled it with life. You filled it with everything that we need to be sustained and to live in peace and harmony. But Father, we turned away from you and your ways. We decided that we wanted to go our own way. We ate of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, and we followed an evil path. And yet you never gave up on us. You chose a particular people, the Israelites, and blessed them with a covenant and said, "You will be mine forever, and you will be a blessing to the whole world." And indeed they have been, and we thank you for our Jewish brothers and sisters. In the fullness of time, O Lord, you raised from among them a Messiah, an anointed King of all kings and Prince of Peace. He loved all and called us to love everyone, even our enemies. He called us to show the same mercy that he showed to everybody and said, "Come here and gather with me. Let's break bread together. Let's get to know one another. I want to tell you some stories." And as he told stories, Lord, their eyes were opened, their ears were opened, their minds, their bodies, their spirits were filled with your Holy Spirit. And so as we break this bread today, O Lord, we ask that you would send your Spirit upon us and help us, O Lord, to know that we ourselves are the body of Christ sent out to fill the world with the things of the kingdom of heaven. Lord, as we drink this cup, fill us with mercy to overflowing so that we might reach out to the downtrodden and touch their lives, that we would feed the hungry, that we would provide water to the thirsty, that we would clothe the naked, that we would visit the prisoner, that we would be there for your lonely ones. And Lord, we take a moment now to lift up to you particular people and places on our hearts and minds. Touch them, Lord. Help us to be visible signs of your invisible grace, Lord, just as these signs that Jesus gave us are the same. And as we feast this day, O Lord, help us to remember you, all that you have done for us, all that you will do for us. Help us to remember that we belong to you forever and ever, and that your love will never let us go. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, even though we are apart in distance, right now we are one in the Spirit. So enjoy the feast that our Lord and Savior has prepared.
on this Labor Day weekend, I charge you to give some thought and prayer to those who are struggling in this difficult time. Reach out to those you know who are seeking employment, those who are underemployed, those who are worried about their job security. I also charge you to think about the wonderful work that God has done on behalf of all humanity, how he came into our flesh and transformed it, how he magnified the image of God inside all of us, and how he was willing to go to the cross that we might know the gift of eternal life. Knowing that hope, go out into the world and love everyone you meet. Now receive a blessing. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore. And God's people say,
like a bird on a tree, I'm just sitting here. I got time, it's clear to see. From up here, the world seems small.